Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing modeling with linear equations. Let's go ahead and do this example. After a 15% price reduction, a computer sold for $1,200. What was the original price? Let's carefully work through this problem solution. So in word problems like this, you typically want to let your variable be what you're looking for. So because we're looking for the original price, I'm going to let x be equal to the original price. And now we need to write an equation to model this word problem. So we're told that after a 15% price reduction, the computer sold for $1,200. So we know that it sold for $1,200. I'm going to put that over here on the right-hand side of this equation. So that's how much it sold for. But we also know that it sold at a 15% price reduction. We have to think about what that means. That basically means it sold for 15% less than the original price. So that's the original price minus 15% of the original price. So of in mathematics means multiply. So 0.15 times x. Again, it's the original price, which is x, minus 15% of the original price, because of means multiply. There's really an invisible 1 here in front of the x. It's implied. So you can subtract these. 1x minus 0.15x is 0.85x. And this is equal to 1200. And to solve for x, since it's being multiplied by 0.85, we just divide by 0.85 and then divide the other side by 0.85. These cancel, and so we end up with x equals, and this is an approximation, approximately equal to $1,411.77. So this is roughly the original price of the computer. Pretty cool. Again, in these problems, you always identify what you're looking for with your variable x. So again, here x was the original price. And then you have to create your equation. I'll do it one more time down here in blue. We know it sold for $1,200. But we also know it sold at a 15% price reduction. What does that mean? That means it sold for the original price minus 15% of the original price, right? So, and then we subtracted. There's a 1 here in front of the x. So we subtract these and got 0.85 like we did up here, and then we divided and finished up. So kind of a nice problem because it forces you to think a little bit about what a price reduction actually is. Hopefully you've learned some math in this video. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.